You mentioned a bunch of areas in which you believe the world is, and the country is better than it was at the beginning. Are race relations in this country, having nothing to do with the president, are race relations in this country better today? This has been a hell of a year, as
it relates to...
It began with Ferguson about a year ago, Baltimore, Sandra Bland. We've had a conversation all year long about Black Lives Matter, about race and incarceration, about race and policing. You mentioned the Voting Rights Act anniversary, which was this year. But we seem really to be kind of in a weird place as far as race in this country. What's going on?
And I know you, I want to be respectful of your time.
That's okay.
But I want to take you back to election night.
Yeah.
Because it was just magical for me. And I watched every TV show. I ran the Obama campaign for Texas. I made the decision I wanted to be here. I didn't want to be in Chicago. And I just wanted to absorb everything. And I just, I was more proud that it felt like that night for just a few hours. We laid aside all of our sheens and said, you know what, whether you love Obama, Democrat, or Republican, this is a uniquely American achievement. And everywhere we went as USTR, the first 6 months I got nothing done because I'd go into a country and they would have to explain to me what a big deal it was that Barack Obama was president. And that wouldn't happen in any other country because every other country, for the most part, was 90% homogenous. They weren't elect anybody from a different faith. And so we celebrated that. And I remember the next day we talked about what it meant and all the great things and are we post-racial. And one commentator said, this has absolutely brought out the best of America. But I'm afraid it's also going to bring out the worst in America. And what we've seen happen, and I'm not going to sit here and tell you, with Barack Obama not only occupying that White House, but having been reelected twice, and reelected the second time by the largest vote since Roosevelt, and the only president reelected with unemployment above 10%, that we haven't made progress. I can't sit here as all of those honorifics you gave me and say we haven't had progress. But I'm also not blind enough to ignore the reality when you see the sort of venom spewed at this president every day and the Republican Party sort of looking the other way at that. If you challenge the very birthright of this president, his respect, then we had a gubernatorial candidate who brought Ted Nugent in here, you know, called the president a mongrel. But then how easy it for a police officer seeing a black kid walking down the street with his pants hanging down and a hoodie to give that kid value. And I don't think it's an accident at all that the extraordinary attempts to delegitimize Barack and Michelle Obama hadn't trickled down to manifest itself at a level that people feel like that all of a sudden it's okay to do that.